Welcome back to Computer Graphics and Visualization subject. In that we are discussing Module 5. Today we will finish Module 5. But in today's session we are discussing what are the APIs available in OpenGL to draw curves and surfaces. Right? That part we will discuss. Then we will wind up Module 5. Here, curves and surfaces in OpenGL. Means what are the APIs available, how to make use those APIs to draw curves and surfaces in OpenGL. That is curves and surfaces in OpenGL. There is a concept called evaluators. Evaluators, what they will do? Evaluators are a general mechanism for working with the Bestian polyomino. These are the functions. They take some inputs, right, then generate some coordinates, right, that is depending on the Bestian polynomial. Bestian polynomial we are discussing in Bezier curve, and we are discussing theoretical concept of Bezier curve, Bestian polynomials, right. These evaluators can use any degree polynomials. Any degree polynomials can be given input for these evaluators, but we will prefer a cubic polynomial degree 4, I mean it's a degree 3, right, which has a 4 control points, right, that we will prefer because these are the feasible polynomials for drawing. If you take a lesser degree, then approximation becomes very difficult. If you take a higher degree, then the complexity will increase. That's why the reason we will prefer degree 3, that is cubic polynomials, right. Then these can used in 1 to any 4 dimensions. Means if you want, you can use in 1 dimension, 2 dimension, 3 dimension, 4 dimensions, right. These automatically generate generation of normals and texture coordinates. Means these will generate normals and texture coordinates for any drawing, right. Then available quadrics, APIs available for quadrics are, there are different two types, different APIs available. Some APIs are available in GLU and some are available in GLUT, right, containing polynomial approximations of quadric 3. As I told, APIs are available in OpenGL, there are APIs available in GLU library, there are APIs available in GLUT library, contains polynomial approximation of quadric 3, means cubic polynomials can be approximated here. Then one dimensional evaluators, two dimensions, as I told, there are evaluators for 1 to 4 dimensions. First we will discuss one dimensional evaluator, right, evaluator, a Bestian polynomial of any degree at a set of specified values. As I told, any degree will take, but we will discuss for one dimension. Can evaluate variety of variables. It will evaluate variety of variables, points along the 2, 3 and 4 dimensional curves. Points along the 2, 3 and 4 dimensional curves can be evaluated, right. It will evaluate colors, normal, texture coordinates, right. Then how to use? You can set up a multiple evaluators that are all evaluated for the same value. If you want, you can set up multiple evaluators for all evaluated for a same value. Then how to set up a evaluator, setting up a evaluator, right. Here the function available in OpenGL, that is GL map 1F. Since we are discussing one dimension, that is 1F. If you are going for two dimensions, this will become 2F, then 3F, 4F, like this. This will tell how many dimension evaluator you are evaluating, right. That's why since it is 1F, then the function name is small GL map 1F. Then first parameter is what you want to evaluate. What you want to evaluate? Do you want to evaluate point? Do you want to evaluate color? What you want to evaluate? Right? That's why I told color, normal, texture coordinates. What you want to evaluate? That's why again points. Actually, what you want to evaluate? That type. Right? Then maximum and minimum U. U varies from 0 to 1. That maximum and minimum U you have to specify here. Right? Then stride. Separation between data points. Means offset. Separation between data points. What is the offset? Data points you are using, right, separation between data points. Then order, that order is 1 plus degree of polynomial. Order is always degree of polynomial plus 1. As I told, Bezier curve will be drawn with 4 control points, but the polynomial is cubic polynomial. You are using a cubic polynomial, so degree of polynomial is 3. That's why order is 1 plus always degree of polynomial. Then pointer to array, pointer to control data. Then which data you want to control, that is a pointer to array. Means where you have kept your, if you are drawing your points, then where the array, where is that array, that address you have to specify here, right. Each type must be enabled by GL enable underscore type. Each type must be enabled first, right? If you want to draw vertex, then vertex has to be enabled, color, color has to be enabled, normal, normal has to be enabled. Before using, each type must be enabled by using a GL enable type. Right, then only this GL map will work, right? GL map 1 for 1 dimension, 2 here for 2 dimension, 3 for 3 dimension, 4 for 4 dimension, right? Then example, one example, consider an evaluator for a cubic Bezier curve over 0 and 1. Or 0 and 1, right? Point data means points data. Here you write the points, 3D, 3 dimensional data. Sorry, 3 dimensional data. This is array. Then GL map 1, yeah, GL map 1 dimensional evaluator, right? GL map vertex. That's why I am evaluating for vertex. If I am evaluating for vertex, then vertex, then that is a 3 vertex, then 0 and 1. That is U, he has mentioned 0 to 1. That is U, minimum U, maximum U. That is 0 to 1. Then 3. Data arranged in x, y, z, means continuously. Means data offset. That means always you consider continuous three values for evaluating. Always you consider continuous three values for evaluating, then give me one point. It gives one point which has x, y, z. Again, next x, y, z, like this. Then cubic. Degree cubic means cubic polynomial order. We have to mention here order. You have to mention order. It's a cubic polynomial, but cubic polynomial order is, means always order will take degree plus 1, that is a 4. Then data, where is your points? Your points are here. Your points are here. That is 3 fourths between data points in array. 3 fourths between data points in array, right? The data are 3D vertices. Data are 3D vertices that we are given here, right? Then GL enable, GL map vertex 3. Means you have to enable this vertex 3, right? Always vertex 3. It has to consider, right? Then whenever it is calculating points, it has to calculate between 0 to 1. Then the intervals must be uniform, unique intervals. You consider unique intervals from 0 to 1. Then consider always 3 points from the array. Then cubic polynomial. Then these points are in this, right? This is one example how to evaluate the one dimensional evaluation, right? Then evaluating. The function GL evaluate color. Color, as I told, it can evaluate color, the one dimensional UF, right? Again, this can be used for GL, evaluation, color, right? That is one F. Causes all enable evaluators to be evaluated for the specified U. Specified U can replace GL vertex, GL normal, GL text chord, GL text coordinate, means GL coordinate, right? One F. Then the value of U need not be equally spaced. The value need not be, here there is no compulsion, the value U need not be equal, means interval from 0 to 1 need not be equally spaced. For example, consider the previous evaluator that was set up for the cubic Bezier curve over 0 and 1. 0 and. Suppose that we want to approximate the curve with a 100 point polynomial, 100 point polyline, 100 point polyline. Then how to use GL begin, GL underscore line strip. Then for I equal to 0, I less than 100, I plus plus, GL, evaluate coordinate 1F, then floating point I by 100. Means you are calculating, you are evaluating this one for I by 100. Means first I by 100, you will get some value, then next I by 100, you will get some, means interval. This is interval. This again, there is no compulsory that these are equally spaced. But equally spaced also works. Then it will draw a line strip. Means first point to next point, it will draw one line. The next point it will draw one line, like this it will draw. This is your coordinates, means always it will calculate the coordinate values in these intervals, right? Then these will be joined by line strip. So this is one example, GL value coordinate. Then Bezier surface, right? To draw a Bezier surface, again we have the APIs in OpenGL. By using those APIs you can draw Bezier surface, right? How to draw a Bezier surface, already in one of the experiment we have seen this one. Similar procedure to 1D, but use 2D evaluators in U and V. Use 2D evaluators in similarly 1D, but use 2D evaluator in U and V. Right? Set up with GL map 2F, GL map 2F type. Then what type? Again, as I told, color, matrix, vertex, what type? Then U minimum, U max. U mean U max, U stride, U order, right? Order means order of two polynomial, you consider order. Then V minimum, V max, V stride means again two dimensional evaluator. This is U and V. That's right. Two dimensions, two points we require. Means right? then we are the pointer to a data, pointer to a data. Then evaluate with GL evaluate coordinate, NF GL evaluate for 2F UV, right? By using this one, we can evaluate, draw the Bezier curve, right? Means you have to evaluate the what type of points you want to evaluate, then between those points you draw your curve, right? This is the direct function, API is available in OpenGL. One example, cubic over 01 and 01. Cubic over 01 and points data, 4, 4, means how many control points, how many control points, that is total number of control points 4, then each have 4 points, then 4 values, then GL map 2F, GL map vertex 3, GL map vertex 3, then U 0, maximum 1, then 3, that is order, order is 3, U order is 3, and U is stride is 3, means always you have to consider 3 points, from this always you have to consider 3 points, then 4, that is order, then V minimum, again V minimum is 0, maximum is 1, then 12. Note that in V direction, data points are separated by 12 floats since array data is stored by rows. Array data is stored, means where you will get U values, after 12 numbers from this array, you will get the next points for this vertex, this V, right? That is where, means where you will get next value, always they start at 12. Means note that in V direction, data points are separated by 12 floats since array data is stored by rows. Array data is stored by rows, right? Means you will get for this second V, you will get data at 12th index, means offset from this, from starting 0 index, if you start 12th index, you will get the values for V. Then again, this is a 4, then data available here. Both are referring data from this, but this will start data continuously 3, means first 3, next 3, next 3. Then for this, for second one, it has to start at again, it has to take its own values, again 3, 3. But where that will begin? It will begin at index 12. In from this array, index 12 it will begin. Then again it is order is 4, then it will consider data from this. Right, like this it will draw a Bezier curve. Right? Yeah. Then next, glut objects, means there are again, yeah, as I told, there are APIs available in GLUT. Some of the APIs available in the GLUT library, the objects can be drawn by using those objects. For example, each has wire and solid frame. Means you can, if you want, you can draw wireframe model, or if you want, you can draw solid frame. Right? If you want to draw a phone, by wireframe model, then GLUT wire phone. Then GLUT, there is an API available, GLUT wire phone. It will draw wireframe. If you want solid, there is a solid phone also can be drawn. Right? Then torus, if you want to draw a torus, then glut wire torus, there is an API available, glut wire torus. Then if you want to draw a teapot, right, glut wire teapot, right, already we have a teapot in teapot program, right, but we have a solid teapot, right. There is again, means there is an API available, primitive, direct primitive available for drawing a teapot, right, that can be used like that. Then glut platonic solids, means if you want to draw a solid objects, right, then glut wire tetrahedron, right, this is tetrahedron will be drawn, then glut wire dot clefhedron, right, this can be drawn, then glut wire octahedron, right, then glut wire exlohedron, right. So like this, there are APIs are available. By using these APIs, again this is the wireframe models, again if you want, you can convert into solids also, right. These are the APIs available for drawing curves and cubic surfaces in OpenGL, right. This completes the module 5. Thank you.